Hello guys, long time no see, and welcome to 2023. So I hope this year will surprise us all in a good way. Well, however it actually did, we have Xenna now. So today, let me tell you a bit more about this new mobile strategy game from SIDUS HEROES called Xenna. We also plan to make guides about Xenna too. So, you know, like we do, exploring the game and telling you about some complex stuff in a simple way. So, if this sounds cool, just drop a like and comment down below. By the way, we have already released an intro guide for Xenna, so I definitely recommend watching this first. But watch this one until the very end, and I promise you, we'll share tons of important stuff you won't find anywhere else. So, basically, today we're going to start with the very, very basics and answer some of the frequently asked questions from the community. And yeah, there's plenty of them. So let's waste no time and let's get it started. Okay, before we move on to the game part, I'd like to tell you a bit more about Xenna itself. So it is the first ever free-to-play mobile real-time strategy game featuring battle royale mechanics. And basically, Xenna is one of the planets of the SIDUS metaverse. Xenna was abandoned by its inhabitants after a meteorite strike that contained deadly bacteria. So this bacteria sort of mutated the natural resources of Xenna, you know, oil in particular, and made them all extremely valuable. And now these resources are hunted by inhabitants of Xenna and, of course, the treasure hunters and explorers. The Xennians themselves were forced out to leave their home and extract resources using robots controlled by orbital stations. However, only female Xennians managed to survive, becoming kind of galactic race of Amazons.
Go home, there are thousands more like me.
Well, don't ask me, this is from the official lore. In a nutshell, the gameplay goes like this. So, 10 players fight in the battle arena that lasts roughly 6 minutes. So you gotta control squads of robots to capture towers while avoiding devastating dust storms that shrinks the map. And obviously, the last one standing wins. The game can be played from both mobile devices and desktop. And by the way, the devs recently added a desktop version, so luckily we don't need emulators anymore. Both versions can be found on the official website. Just check out the link in the description below. And by the way, soon Xenna will be added to Google Play, so looking forward to that. The desktop version is available for macOS that I have and Windows, while the mobile is only suitable for Android so far. So hopefully they'll add iOS soon. Just go to the website, choose an appropriate version and click on it. The download will begin immediately. If you got the desktop app, you just need to unpack the archive and launch the game using the Xenna file. If you choose the mobile app, just find it in the download folder and install it. Android may warn you about some risks, but there are certainly none. So you will see a Xenna icon on the screen of your device and just launch it. So speaking of the differences between versions, well, I think interface-wise, they are pretty much the same. However, the desktop version received some improvements in the latest patch. So let's go through them. Mouse navigation has been updated. They also added an option to quit the app by clicking the escape button. Besides, some hotkeys were added, like ones for managing the camera to the WASD and arrow key. We can now access a list of players with the tab button and also see the whole map by pressing this long space button. Personally, now I play PC version because, well, I like the navigation options more and the laptop is always with me. But in general, well, I think the playability of mobile version is pretty much the same, or even better in some cases, due to mobility and touchscreen navigation. Anyways, the sessions are pretty short and you can play the game from anywhere. So I definitely recommend you stay tuned for the game updates, as there will be lots of events with rich prizes and important in-game changes. So you can check all the updates on social media or the blog. Of course, links will be in the description below. Okay, so you've launched Xenna, and the first thing you need to do is to enter your email. Well, the real one that you have access to. Then you'll receive a verification code that you need to enter. If there is no message appearing, just check your spam folder. After that, you'll be given a free in-game character and an option to choose a nickname. Next, you'll be transferred to the lobby. Well, yeah, looks familiar, right? Let's figure out what you should do before starting the game, okay? In the main screen, click here on your character, and you'll be taken to the characters menu. So what you can do here, change character if you have multiple NFTs. See the status under the character's name, free, common, epic, and legendary. It is your type of NFT. Also, you can use items, but they haven't been introduced yet. Distribute talents into four characteristics: attack, vitality, agility, and defense, all by analogy with SIDUS Heroes. However, talents don't work yet either. Stats will affect the HP, damage, defense, and the speed of your robots. So far, it's quite hard to predict the best builds in the game. So what do you say? Let's come back another time and make a separate video guide when talents will finally work. So support this idea with your thumbs up, please. Okay, I want to answer right away that only three characters are present in the game. So, well, chill out, guys. We're in the early beta. The NFT sale is planned for February, and the airdrop for the Genesis Collection owners will take place like around the same date. And lucky ones who get their Xenna NFTs from Dropboxes will have to wait too. February is our reference point. So should you join the open beta? Well, yeah, for sure, as all accumulated progress will remain after the official launch. So do you smell that early advantage as I do? Okay, so let's continue. If you click on the gear above the characters, you'll be taken to the profile. Everything is quite simple here. You can change your nickname, get a copy of your ID, control sounds and music, enable the display of players' nicknames in the game. Also, you can log out. Of course, read privacy policy, the most important thing. You can also contact support and go to Discord room to chat with other players. As for rewards, there are plenty of them. If you click on the cup, you'll get to Trophy Road. And if you click rewards in the lobby, you'll see free daily and weekly rewards. Well, I think this definitely deserves a separate guide about like loot, gifts, and etc. In the upper right corner, you can find your balance. For Xenna, there are two main assets, G-Cell and G-Ore. Well, not Gore, I guess. You can win the first one in battles, while the latter is a premium stuff. You'll be able to buy it in the future, I guess. What's working for sure in the game is the robot's stats. Just click on units or the robot itself, and you'll be taken to the robots page. Here, you can distribute talent points and choose some skills. Well, in my opinion, this process requires a guide too, so don't you dare to miss it. The last thing left for us is to deal with the bottom panel. Everything is quite simple here, but still, let me explain that to you. A menu for buying a premium account that allows you to receive rewards more than 50%. But as you cannot purchase Gore right now, you cannot go premium so far. Here you can buy rare skills, loot boxes, G-Cell, Gore, and also pick up a daily free gift, Forge. And here you can improve skills. For this, you need to select a skill and provide two additional cards of the same skill. So I guess this makes three in total. And by the way, don't forget about shards too. Inventory, and here where all the resources that you get from battles will be displayed. So I hope this one is quite clear. Top 100, and this is the rating of the best players ranked by earned cups. Mode, here you can choose different game modes, but only solo is available so far. Rumor has it that in the future, it'll be possible to play in co-op mode with your friends. And the last one, the fight button, well, simply to start the game. Okay, so it is high time to play. Well, you bet it. But I think this topic certainly deserves special attention and a separate guide in detail. So we'll explain some basic tactics, type of towers, in-game interface, and as always, answer some of your questions. Okay, deal? Then drop a like to seal it. And also, don't forget to leave your questions in the comment section down below. Personally, I think that Xenna has all the right potential to turn into like something bigger, something interesting. So let's keep our eye on it and their progress together.